Now, I want to talk about what it is like to be a woman in a male-dominated field. A lot of people have spoken about how to combat male advances, how to succeed in a male-dominated environment, but let's face it, some days are harder than most. And I will tell you why. Because innately as females, we are taught that you never ever challenge a man. You never ever make a man feel threatened. At least that's a cultural norm. That you must make them feel safe, that you must never ever make them feel like you're a threat. That unless when you do that, when you make them feel like you are a threat, you are demanding them. Is that even a word? Demanding? I don't know. Anyway, let me tell you something. They have meetings where, you know, your opinion is not required. They have bonuses where yours must be calculated lower because, of course, you wouldn't know what it's like to be part of something that's so risky, financially, health-wise, safety, all that stuff. So let me tell you something. In my experience, I have learned a few things about how to deal with men in the workplace. I have learned that you do not have to tone down your femininity. I'll tell you why. Men expect you to become them, but you will never be them. They want you to buy the suits, the square box shoes, act like you're really tough, like you can get in there. The problem is that you're not built like them. Everything about your body is not built like them. So now therein lies the problem. It doesn't matter how hard you try to be like them, you'll never be a man. So now I learned one thing. I started to embrace my femininity in a very male-dominated world. What that does for you is very simple. It gives you not so much as a cover. It gives you a safety net. You're not denying innately who you are, but also they will let you in thinking that you're more of a simpleton, you're more simplistic, you will not understand certain things, which allows you to see a bigger picture. So let's not dismiss the high heels. Let's not dismiss your makeup or your hair, because as women, we want to look good. I don't know about you, but being an engineer should never take away from my looks or what I want to do with my hair or what I want to wear with jewelry. You know what? Like I always say, the world is my runway. So I learned a few things dealing with men in the workplace. I refuse to deny my innate femininity. Is that a word? Omanyo Uganda, and I wrote English is also, even if my father paid it. But I also refuse to deny my femininity. Innately, men want to be listened to. So you listen, you smile, you don't say much, you're never confrontational. But at the end, please make sure that your opinion is heard. And do it gently and precisely, classy, with dignity. But make sure you nail whoever needs to be nailed to the wall without confrontation. As women, we're being told that feminism is about combating people, combating men. You must go to war. No, it's not really that. Women, we guide men. And the idea that you can fight a man on their own terms is ridiculous. I'm just saying this. But they will listen if you start off with gentlemen and messieurs. I'd like to just point out a few things that I've noticed during this meeting. And I think, from my humble opinion, because of course women, we're humble. That's what we've been taught. And trust me, it's the biggest weapon, because we are the most multifunctional brains ever to grace this planet. Because our mothers have taught us that you do not shout. You sit there and you say it with class and dignity. You say, gentlemen and messieurs, I'd like to offer my humble opinion in A, B, C, and D. They nail them to the cross. And when you finish, you say, you know, I just wanted to put it out there because I feel like we missed it throughout the whole thing.